Great rally. It's these kind of events that really give a spirit to the people that move them. What I thought it was especially good about today was that we had a lot of people from the Asian community and island community, and thought it was wonderful. But we also should hear from Shankar, who's with ACLU and an immigrant advocate and an attorney, who is here with us today. So I want to turn it over to Shankar.
Well, Leno is too kind, and I thought this was a great event. You know, we need people to come out and show power in the streets to really show the politicians in Washington that this is not a dead issue. As much as they think that, you know, they've done their bit by just doing healthcare reform, this is really an issue where we can't wait anymore. You know, people's lives are being affected by this. Every year we wait is more people separated from their families, more children separated from their parents, more people waiting in line for green cards, more people who can't get jobs that contribute to our economy. You know, we need all of that, and we need it now. So this was awesome. As Leno said, you know, people from all across the state, you know, people from schools, people from Microsoft, people from growers, leagues, this is everybody's issue, and we need our politicians to take heed and do it now.
And how do people get a hold of people in order to participate?
Well, you can go to the One America website and get connected with one of their organizers. That's the best way. You can also go to the ACLU of Washington website. We work on the parts of this that relate to due process in the immigration system. You know that there's not a lot of that, unfortunately. And then I would also direct you to the Northwest Immigrant Rights Project's website. If you have a specific issue, they can help connect you with an attorney to deal with that.
Thank you very much for being on my show.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Now take it.
Yeah.
Now hold it.
Yeah. Woo. It's supposed to be Columbus. We misspelled it. Sorry.
All right, he goes to college too.
Because in Minneapolis, 1,200 janitors, union janitors, were fired again by another I-9 audit. That is unacceptable. The problem is, after the audit happened, the employer gets fined and they pay it, but the workers end up with no jobs, end up homeless, and that's not right for our communities, and we're gonna fight to pass immigration reform. One more thing. We elected President Obama to work with us, not against us. We elected him to help us pass comprehensive immigration reform, not to increase the deportations, not to increase the number of the I-9 audits that is happening right now. So we are now here to demand, not to ask, to demand that the I-9 audit stop. We also need the legalization of the 12 million undocumented workers that work now under the table, that work under unfair working conditions, because they need and they have the right as workers in this country. So we also need a bill that passes the respect of workers and labor rights with a path to citizenship. And finally, we demand not just from President Obama, but from our two senators and from the Congress people in this state, this is the time we need their leadership. We need a bill in Congress. Aquí estamos sindicatos unidos para luchar por la reforma migratoria y estamos apoyando todos los esfuerzos que se están haciendo. Es una vergüenza que nuestros trabajadores que vienen y trabajan duro en este país tengan que sufrir las consecuencias por las auditorías que el gobierno está realizando ahorita. Nosotros perdimos 120 trabajadores en Minneapolis, perdieron otros 1,200 en Brewster, Washington, perdieron otros más en Bellingham igual. So, esta situación tiene que parar, pero la única forma de pararlo es nosotros exigiendo que se paren las auditorías, que se nos dé legalización, que se nos den derechos laborales y civiles y que se nos dé una pauta hacia la ciudadanía. Lo demandamos no solo de Obama, sino de nuestras senadoras y de nuestros representantes. Necesitamos un bill de reforma migratoria y los trabajadores vamos a estar unidos. ¡Gracias!
This right here is the moment where Democrats and Republicans have a choice. They can choose to include generations of immigrant voters, or they can choose to alienate those same voters. Ahora es el momento donde ambos partidos pueden escoger inspirar y incluir generaciones de votantes inmigrantes, o decidir alienar esos mismos votantes. In 2008, we all remember that there was an unprecedented voter turnout in our communities. And Latino, Asian, and other immigrant voters across the country delivered victories to Democrats in Colorado, Nevada, New Mexico, and Florida. And some would say that we did the same in North Carolina, Indiana, and Pennsylvania. One thing is for sure, immigrant votes were responsible for turning red states into blue. But no party, let me say this clearly, no party should take the votes of immigrants for granted. Una cosa está muy, muy segura. Los votantes inmigrantes fueron responsables de cambiar estados tradicionalmente rojos a azules. Pero ningún partido debe despreciar el voto inmigrante. Anti-immigrant messages don't work, won't work, and will never work. And we know that Latino and Asian voters care about immigration reform. 82% of Latino voters say that immigration is personally important to them. And 72% of us say that we will never consider voting for a candidate that advocates a deportation-only policy. 82% de los votantes latinos dicen que la inmigración es personalmente importante para ellos. Y el 72% dicen que no votarán por un candidato que recomiende una política de deportación. No se va a hacer. Los votantes inmigrantes se presentarán en noviembre. Immigrant voters will come out to vote in November. Y nosotros estaremos pendientes de lo que hará nuestro Congreso y el presidente Obama. We will be demandando que el Congreso pase la reforma migratoria y que Obama firme la reforma migratoria.
¡Gracias, Morena! Bueno, ven, la gente está un poquito apagada. ¿Dónde está mi gente de Washington? La reforma migratoria, ¿qué queremos? Más duro, ¿qué queremos? ¿Qué queremos? ¿Y cuándo la quieren? ¿La quieren en 15 años? ¿La quieren en 20 años? ¿La quieren este año? ¿La quieren este año? Muy bien. Okay, now we want to close by inviting a couple of important DJs who have been mobilizing people through the radio to come out today and will continue to be our allies in our demand for immigration reform legislation to be introduced no later than May 1st so that it can pass this year. We're going to welcome Horacio Alameda and Rafael Granados. Les quiero invitar a dos personalidades de la radio que van a presentarnos y hablar de la reforma migratoria, Rafael y Horacio Alameda.
Noches interminables de llanto, sufrimiento que han tenido nuestras familias.
Yes.
Hemos dejado nuestros pueblos.
Yes.
Nuestras familias sufren cada día que no nos ven.
Yes.
Hemos construido este país con nuestras manos.
Yes.
Debemos tener una reforma justa ahora, ahora, ahora. No queremos políticos que nada más vengan a tomarse la foto y se vayan. Queremos que luchen con nosotros, día con día, hora con hora. Nuestros hijos necesitan de políticos dignos que nos den credibilidad para tener esa reforma que ya pronto no estará en el curso de decir sí se puede, sino decir sí se puede,
sí se puede,
sí se puede. Lo vamos a lograr, lo vamos a lograr con la lucha de cada uno de nosotros, incansable, incansable, día con día. Vamos hasta que en próximos días, en próximos meses, tengamos esa reforma que los políticos nos han ocultado.
Como los hispanos, soy su servidor Horacio Ahumada, de Comentando las Noticias todos los días. Y voy a echar ganas para que todo el mundo escuche que sí se va a poder. Tenemos la fe y sobre todo que vamos a cuidar la dignidad para que no nos anden presionando allá afuera, para que no nos anden amenazando que no tenemos papeles, para no sentirnos escondidos, para salir a la luz pública, pero ¿saben una cosa? Para también ir a visitar a nuestras familias en nuestros países que nos están esperando. Mucha gente ha perdido a sus padres, mucha gente ha perdido familias, no han tenido la oportunidad de ir a nuestros países. Créanme, el año que entra vamos a ir muchos a nuestros países porque van a ser libres totalmente. Que podamos andar en la calle, inclusive que podamos ir hasta el Walmart, ¿por qué no? Ya que ahorita se está manejando eso. Les vamos a ayudar con mucho gusto. La radio es de ustedes. Felicidades.
Give yourself a nice big round! Thank you so much for being here today! We want immigration reform! What do we want?
What do we want?
hoy, como pueden ver, sin voz, pero las voces de ustedes van a seguir resonando para que nuestros representantes los escuchen y los oyen, porque ellos tienen que aprobar la reforma inmigratoria este año. ¡Sí se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
¡Se puede! ¡Se puede!
¡Se puede!
¡Se puede!
¡Sí se puede!
¡Sí se puede! ¡Así es! ¡Así es! ¡Sí se puede! Todos ustedes así deben estar muy orgullosos de lo que han hecho presentándose aquí para que sepa la gente que la gente se debe respetar. Quiero darles felicitaciones a todos ustedes y vamos a terminar aquí nuestro programa con el mariachi rey de México que ha venido desde Guanachi para entretenerlos a ustedes. Un gran aplauso para finalizar a todos ustedes. Muchas gracias, thank you very much. Keep up the hard work. And here's Mariachi Rey de México from Guanachi.
Come on.
Take this too if you want. It's a new book.
Well, this is an immigration reform rally. We're trying to work to make sure that immigration reform happens this year.
And how did you organize so many people?
Well, we've been working as part of a coalition. Our organization is the Northwest Immigrant Rights Project, but we've been working with a coalition of over 60 organizations throughout the state of Washington that have been working together to bring as many people as possible here. We were able to get many buses from different parts of the state to come down here so that they could travel all the way to Seattle. And with that, we had thousands of people, as you can see today.
Very nice turnout.
we did, and I think the weather cooperated with us today, which was wonderful, but I think it's also because people are just very energized. They're very focused on the fact that this is something that needs to happen today and not, you know, next year or 10 years from now. We need to have this reform happen today.
Nice. And then how did you decide on Pioneer Square?
Well, I think there was a lot of issues with the permits, with the police, and with the city of Seattle. So we had a lot of different discussions about locations. But in the end, this was the location that worked for both the city and for the police and for us. And so this is how we ended up in this area.
Because it's really nice to have you guys down here.
Well,
it's a nice location, and it was a beautiful day for this kind of a thing.
I thought the location actually worked out beautifully, and you know, the fact that we're here right in the downtown of Seattle, where people came as pioneers, is also part of the whole message of us, that you know, the world changes over time, and we need to have new energy, and this is a place where people came to energize this region. And now there's a new generation of pioneers, of immigrants, and we need to make sure that we're a welcoming society for them.
Nice. And then how do people get a hold of you? Do you guys have a website?
We do have a website. Well, we have the coalition website is actually Washington Immigration Reform Coalition for America. So if you Google that, you'll get that. And then we have also for our organization is the Northwest Immigrant Rights Project, and our website is nwirp.org.
Very nice. Well, I'm totally delighted that we were here today. This was a great, great rally.
Well, I'm glad that people are here too today too, and we had such a great turnout.
And to experience it. It's very, very nice.
Great.
Thank you for putting it on.
Absolutely. We're very happy, and we were glad that people were able to participate.
Very nice. Thank you very much. Great. Thanks for
Thank
being
you.
On my show.
No problem.
Big time. It was a great event.
Thank
One
you.
Of the best.
Wasn't that great? Thank you.
All right.
Bye.
Glad you made it to this event.
Thank you. It was great. Thanks for inviting me last night.
Oh, no problem.
Thank
I'm
you.
I'm glad you were able to attend and hope everybody enjoyed it.
It was great.
Thanks.
It was a really good event.
Yeah, definitely. It was terrific.
Thank
Thanks
you.
So much. Uh-huh.
Bye.
Take care. Bye.